Well, the year to 31st of January 2018 was our 10th full year, our 9th year of continuous NAV growth per share. We're up 16.2% in US dollar terms. We're a very US dollar orientated company. We have 75% of our assets that are linked to the US dollar, either directly or indirectly. Translated into sterling, because of the strength of sterling, the share price, which we're quoted in, is only up 4.8%, but it's a further year of slow and steady growth in sterling on the back of a really satisfactory year in US dollars.
So this year we delivered very strong NAV growth, 16.2% in US dollars. That was led by the secondary portfolio, which delivered 18.7% growth in the year. So secondaries led the other two strategies, primary and direct co-investment. Those combinations, those contributions do change from year to year, but secondaries were particularly strong in this year. We've also seen variation by geography. So we actually saw Europe growing at the fastest rate relative to the US and Asia. So Europe grew at 21.9% of the year. Asia was very close, 21.6%. Europe was flattered by FX effects as the euro appreciated against the US dollar. The performance in the year demonstrates that the long-term strategy that HVPE has adopted is working, continues to work. The realizations in the year were a new record in cash terms, $405 million of cash received. That is a mixture of an increase in genuine exit activity in the portfolio and also, to some extent, recapitalizations in the portfolio delivering cash early. But nevertheless, that's still a record, up from $270 million in the prior year. So those realizations really feed through into NAV growth because we're seeing an uplift in terms of the value realized versus the carrying value of those same assets. That uplift has tended to be above 30%, I mean, for 6 years in a row. This year it's 31% again. So we're seeing this very consistent trend towards realizations coming through at a significant uplift. We're continuing with the same strategy that we've had since the IPO. We're a majority investor in the US. We do have increasing exposure to Asia, and we're backing some of the most innovative venture capital managers in that region. But we should always remember that the portfolio is global, it's very well balanced, all backed up by a strong balance sheet with a credit facility that now extends out to December 2022. And we are planning every year to try to renew that credit facility so that we always have a minimum of 4 years to run. That gives additional support to the balance sheet, helps to support commitments over time, and enable us to continue to deliver the kind of growth rates that we have demonstrated in recent years.